In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a seamless pattern in GIMP. Let's go. So here we have GIMP open, and now we're going to set up our canvas. I'm using an 8x8 canvas with 300 dpi. Towards the bottom, under Advanced Options, I'm selecting Fill with Transparency, and then click OK. Now that we have our canvas, let's open up some images we're going to use. I downloaded these from Pixabay, and I'm just right-clicking on the image and selecting Open with, and then choosing GIMP. Now we're going to select the image with Control A, then copy it with Control C. Select the window of the canvas you just made, then go to Edit, Paste As, and then select New Layer. Then repeat the process for the second image. So now we have our two new layers, and I'm just going to scale them down a bit better so they fit inside my canvas. I'm going to use a scale tool, and with the scale tool selected, just click on the image to bring up the bounding box. Now you can just click and drag to resize. To move the selection before applying the scale, just click and drag on the center node. Once you have it where you want it, press Enter to apply the scale. Now we'll repeat this process with the other flower layer. To keep the scaling proportionate, hold down the Shift button while dragging. For this one, I press the Scale button to apply the scale. Then to move it, I use the Move tool. Now I'm just arranging the top flower layer using the Rotate tool and the Move tool. I have them where I want them, so let's add some more layers to this design. Once I have the image open that I want to use, I'm just going to repeat the process that I used for the flowers. Once the image is a new layer, I click on that layer and drag it below the flower layers. Now I'm just using the eraser tool to roughen up the edges of this layer. Clicking on the box next to the brush name will bring up a selection of different brushes you can use. Now I'm going to give the background some color. I'm going to use the bucket tool, making sure that the fill type is set to foreground color fill. Since I don't want it white, I'm going to use the color picker or eyedropper tool. To select the color I want, I'm going to click on the layer with the paper and position the dropper tool over the color I want. Then left click and select it. Then I select the background layer and fill it with the bucket tool. I'm going to merge my flower layers into one layer, and I do this by right-clicking on the top flower layer and selecting Merge Down. Then, at the bottom of the layer panel, I'm going to click on the Duplicate Layer icon. This next step is important to do before we make the design into a pattern. For each layer, select all, go to Layer, and Crop to Selection. After that, go to Layer, Transform, and then select Offset. This will bring up the offset menu. Select by width 2 and by height 2. This will fill in the X and Y pixel offset evenly on your canvas. For edge behavior, you want to select Wrap Around. Then click Offset to apply. This splits your design so it lines up perfectly on each corner. So now we're going to repeat that same process with our paper text layer. This time, I cropped the layer to selection before I duplicated it. Now, I'm just adding in other elements to the design to fill in some of the blank spaces. So, now that I've gotten all my design elements where I want them, I'm just gonna fiddle with some of the transparency modes and see what I can come up with. You know, something that I think looks good. Once I've gotten all of it looking the way I want, it's time to export it. Just go to File, Export As, and then name it. Select where you want to save it, and then hit export. You can make many different coordinating patterns from the same file just by turning off and on different layers and exporting. I ended up making 22 different coordinating seamless patterns from this file. Now all I have to do is upload them to Spoonflower and get them ready to sell. I made the files RGB, and they'll probably not print as vibrant as they appear on screen, because printers only print in CMYK. I also plan to make a few more videos in the future showing how to make seamless patterns in Photoshop and Procreate, as well as how to upload and sell your own designs as fabric or wallpaper on Spoonflower. So that's it for me today. See you next week. Bye!